Hi, I'm Vishnu Subramanian, founder of Jarvis Labs. In this video, we are going to talk about a library called VLLM, which is open source. It is built from team at UC Berkeley. It is used for putting open source models in production as a serving layer. It accelerates the inference layer by optimally utilizing the GPU memory. Traditionally, when you use a LLM model through a PyTorch API, there was a 60 to 70% of GPU memory not being utilized in a very efficient manner due to a particular layer in the LLM called attention layer. There's two components called key and value, which ends up consuming a lot of GPU memory in the native architecture. This particular library created a new concept or a new algorithm called paged attention, which helps in optimally using the GPU memory. And thus, the inferencing has become super fast. There was a research done when this paper was published, which shows that this particular algorithm has a 24x higher throughput compared to Hugging Face library. That is when you just say, you load the model through Hugging Face Transformers API, you pass an input through it, you get a 24x throughput when you just switch it to VLLM. Or if you do an inference through another Hugging Face library called TGI, then you end up getting a 3.5x throughput, right? Which is really cool. This paper was published somewhere in mid of June 2023. Hugging Face has also incorporated some of the changes, or they have incorporated some of the advanced algorithms, which should have increased the performance of Hugging Face TGA also. But what makes VLLM interesting is the licensing, and the code is completely open source and is being contributed by a lot of people. Hugging Face has changed the licensing of TGI slightly so there are some restrictions in the way the library can be used for commercial purpose, but VLLM is completely open source. There are two interesting things that was done by the VLLM library. One is the paged attention algorithm. We will go through it. And the other one is the library itself, which has a fast API server. Fast API is again an amazing Python library which is used for building backend applications. VLLM uses fast API for batching and creating an API. They have multiple servers, the normal server, and then there is an open AI compatible server, which means if you already have an library, or if you're already using OpenAI GPT-4 APIs for some of your applications, you can just use any of the VLLM supported models, and you can replace the GPT-4 API endpoint with VLLM endpoint. Then you can just start using the open source LLM model, right? So they have these two, and they are implemented through this fast API server. So we will look at a very quick demo of how we can quickly trigger a VLLM server, fast API server, and how we can consume it through OpenAI API itself. And before that, let's also go through what is paged attention, why it makes it super interesting, right? Okay, the secret sauce for this entire VLLM is called paged attention. Okay, in the traditional LLM space, there is a concept called key and value tensors. Attention key and value tensor, which happens in the attention layer, which happens to be occupying the most of the GPU memory. For example, a single sequence in Llama 13 billion model ends up taking 1.7 gigabytes of space. They claim that the GPU memory is not properly utilized because of this attention layer. 60 to 80% of the memory is not being utilized. Basically, they also claim what are the problems, right? When you're trying to store such a huge values in a continuous memory, then some of the sentences, some of the sequences can be very short, some of them can be very long. It's very hard to say how much memory you need for every particular sequence. You end up over allocating memory. It's not used optimally. So they introduced this concept called page attention, which is again inspired by two concepts in the operating system world. If you have been using computers for a while, you would have heard about two concepts called virtual memory and paging. Every system computer comes up with a RAM of, let's say, 8 GB RAM or 16 GB RAM. And the higher end servers have much more memory, 256, 512 GB RAM, right? But often there are applications which may run out of memory because of the RAM being not sufficient, right? So the operating systems have come up with a concept called virtual memory, which lets you use the storage layer, the SSDs or the NVMEs or the M2 NVMEs, which are super fast, as an addition to this RAM, right? So paging is also a concept of how optimally you can store the data in the storage layer, which is the secondary storage layer, the SSDs, NVMEs, and how quickly you can switch it to the primary memory RAM. So they, VLLM, the team behind VLLM took this amazing concept and brought it to the attention layer. Instead of storing the key value as long contiguous memory blocks, they started storing these entire thing in blocks. Let's say, for example, they have key and value vectors, which is of size 4, right? And for example, let's say 4, then Alan Turing is trying to predict these words. And there is a kind of a table where you map between each block and where is it exactly stored in the memory, right? This actually makes it super efficient. There is also, this is what I was talking about, right? So block 0, Alan Turing, is that information stored in block 0. And there is a block table which has the exact information of the filled physical block and how many blocks are occupied. And every time there is a new token that is being added to the block, the number of filled slot also increases. This is a very high level of the implementation. I'm pretty sure that the actual implementation is going to be much more complicated. Doing this is also another advantage. Let's say, for example, you want to do sampling. For the same given prompt, you want to generate multiple answers, right? So to do that, you don't need to have duplicate key value pairs. So for some of the sequence, for a part of the sequence, right, you may have the same attention value, key value. So here they show how you can reuse the attention mechanism. For example, the future of artificial intelligence is a subject. So the LLM can take probably two different paths. Whenever it shares a common path, there's a same physical KV cache block, right? And doing this, they were able to use the memory by 90-95%. The reason is you don't have an entire block which is empty. Only the last block, which let's say contains only 4 values, one of the block could be empty or 2 blocks could be empty, right? At max 3. So that's the maximum wastage you end up doing on your GPU, which is super expensive. That's the story behind the paged attention. And there is, how powerful is this to understand? The team behind LLMsys has been using this VLLM for one of their, one of their websites called Chatbot Arena, which has like so many LLM models. You can ask a question and then it kind of answers that question using multiple models, and you can end up voting that. And there is also a leaderboard here. This entire thing, which is a very popular one in the AI space, is powered by VLLM. And there's also another library called FastChat. FastChat uses VLLM, and this entire thing is powered by FastChat and VLLM. Okay. This is super interesting. There are so many libraries now who have started using VLLM. There was a recent meetup somewhere in November, which was showing how many companies have been using VLLM. I think this is contributors. Okay. So as we can see here, Google Cloud, Meta, NVIDIA, Model, Replicate, Scale, AnyScale, SkyPilot, there's so many companies which have been using VLLM. So if you're planning to probably deploy LLM in production, or you want to explore it, probably you should be looking at VLLM, right? So now let's also look at a very quick example of how easy it is to get started or use VLLM, and how you can replace your OpenAI GPT-4 API link with the link that VLLM generates. To do that, what we are going to do is we are going to use an instance in Jarvis Labs, but you can do it on any of your servers or any of your cloud providers. We make it slightly easier for you. So in the Jupyter Lab, I've already installed VLLM because it's going to take some time. I think I would have installed it here. Okay, I've installed it here and I have it running. So I'll tell you exactly the commands that I used. Okay, so I think it should be in the documentation. I've opened some of the links that are required, but not everything. So let's go and look at, okay, the documentation is here. Let's look at the quick start. Okay, let's look at the installation. The installation is super simple. You create an environment and then you install the library. In my case, I went ahead and directly installed the library. The reason is we already have most of the Coda libraries and all, and we run on the official PyTorch Docker version, so it makes it super simple. Once you install the library, go to quick start, which can probably take a few minutes. There are different ways you can run. If you're running on a JupyterLab or Python code, you can call the LLM and pass any Hugging Face model that you want to use. I think they support two kinds of model. One is Hugging Face. I mean, there are different models. You can just pull from Hugging Face very easily. These are some of the examples. All right. And I remember seeing somewhere, okay, there's something called Model Scope. I'm not sure what is this, but I think it's an alternative for Hugging Face Hub, right? And these are like some of the popular architectures. Let's say, for example, there was Mixtrel, which has been very popular in the last few weeks, particularly in December. If you want to use it, you can just copy this and replace. Okay, I'll just kill this thing to show you again. So by default, it starts with the some default model. I think the default model is, what is that? Okay, it's Facebook op 125. But let's say you want to start a new model, just go to the supported models and copy paste the content. It looks like I copied the wrong name. I'm not sure why that happened. Let me quickly go and grab that. Okay, let's right click, say copy, and let's paste it. Okay, we can do this. So what this is going to do is it's going to download the entire thing from Hugging Face. Maybe if it's walled behind a token, you may have to pass in Hugging Face token, but I don't want to wait till that starts. So the default model I've already downloaded. So let me just go and start the default model. So here, as you see, I'm starting with an OpenAI compatible server, but there is also a default server which you can use. The reason I'm doing OpenAI compatible API server, I'll just show you in a minute. Okay, this is up pretty quick. Again, go back to the quick start. There is an example for how to use with OpenAI API. There's a Python API called OpenAI library. There's a Python library called OpenAI, which you can install by, say, pip install OpenAI, or if you already have an application, you just have to replace the URL with what you get here. If you're using Jarvis Labs, what you can do is you can go to the cloud.jarvis and right-click this, copy link address, and then that's how I get this URL that you see here. We do certain things and convert that as an API endpoint, which you can just replace in your application and you should be able to use this, right? In this case, I've already installed OpenAI library and I have this API endpoint token. So now I have this thing. So let me do a shift enter. And it says San Francisco is a large city with world-class shopping and entertainment centers and proximity to blah, 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 right? So you can replace whatever you want. You can change, if you change the model here, let's say with Mixtrel, then you have to change the model here, right? And then you should be able to go with it. This is my first take on VLLM. I'm not an expert at VLLM, but I've been learning about it for some time. So I made this video. As I explore further, I would love to add more content to the upcoming videos about VLLM. There's also a few more things, right, that you can do. You can have multiple GPUs. For example, some models do not run on one single GPU. You can have distributed inferencing. And NVIDIA Triton also has an inference server, which makes things faster, I think. If you're using LangChain, which is like a very powerful way to build LLM applications, then you can easily integrate the VLLM application. You can do a lot more. And if you're interested in looking at the supported models, it's here. I'm going to explore further probably how to deploy it with NVIDIA Triton in the upcoming videos. Hope you like it and hope you find it useful. If you have any information or if you have any feedback, please share it in the comments. I hope you love the video. Thank you. See you on another video. See you. Bye-bye.